As buildings would be constructed to stand the test of time, others had decorative details that didn't last long at all. In fact, some county commissioners forced the artists to go back to the drawing board.
The courthouse was constructed. The architect had designed into the front stoops of the front of the building a grasshopper on each side of the doorway. The grasshopper was supposed to be eaten out of grain. And we had just come out of the grasshopper period, early 30s. And grasshoppers, I'm sure you've heard the stories, would eat anything, including the pitchfork handles. I mean, they just destroyed everything in their sight. And so people had a deep hatred, resentment for grasshoppers. In 1940, the county commissioners apparently had had enough of it that they headlines read that the county board uses chisel to fight the problem. I'm sure there are pictures out there, but we've never found a picture that indicates that.
Early on, county commissioners also had issues with the original murals found in the entrance of the Davison County Courthouse.
The artist that the county commission had hired did not meet any kind of standards that they had, and the kiss of death for him, I guess you might say, was the cartoon that is shown. The guy had a farmer milking a cow from the wrong side. And that just insulted all farmers, and they raised a stink about it. So they took the murals down.
The murals would later be replaced and accepted by county commissioners and the community. Lyle Swenson, president of the Mitchell Area Historical Society, also served as Davidson County Sheriff for 32 years. His stories of the courthouse go beyond construction and decor. He once called the building home. It used to be a common requirement that the county sheriff live in the courthouse.
To the left here is the old living room that we had and the kitchen just inside of this door.
Many times across the state, small jails were either lived in right next to the jail or in a house right next door to the jail. And the jail was left alone. We would, if the wife and I wanted to go to a movie and there was nothing going on, we might go down to a movie and just lock the jail up and there'd be nobody here with the prisoners. Now today you would not even think of doing such a thing, but it was an accepted standard at that time.
Well, it was a common thing because they needed to have a guard for the jail at night. And if the sheriff was in the courthouse, then he took the place of the guard or night watchman there in the courthouse. And most of the sheriffs who lived in the courthouses, then their wives got to cook for the meals for the prisoners, and the sheriff got paid so much a meal for that.
Today, there are still some public safety centers or jails located in or near the courthouse, but many are in need of state-of-the-art technology and have outgrown most county courthouses. Today, the Tripp County Courthouse uses the old sheriff apartment located on fourth floor for storage. Right across the hall from the apartment is where the jail was kept. It still showcases the old jail cell bars, bedding, and even a mural an inmate drew many years ago.